So I've got this tensioner pulley out of my Jeep. So this pulley has a bearing in it that turns out to be a Ford bearing part number. I'll put the number on the screen. There are cross references you can look up to find a compatible bearing. So I've actually ordered some Timken 6203s. But it sounds dry. It sounds like there's dirt in it. I've never replaced this bearing, so now that it's out, we're going to replace the bearing. I'm going to try and push this out with a big C-clamp. It's a 6-inch, like vintage Craftsman C-clamp. I've got a 1-inch impact socket that's nearly the same diameter, not quite. Have that as centered as it can be. And again, we're not super worried about this existing bearing because it's getting replaced. But when we press the new one in, we want to make sure we're not damaging it as we press it in. All right, so then I'm just going to try and put some pressure on this thing. See if it'll push through. It's in there tight, kind of rusted in. Put a little WD-40 in there. The other thing you could use is you could use a vise if you had a big enough vise. I don't know. Oh, there it went. There was a lot of torque pressing in on that thing and it, well, it kind of slipped. Didn't come out, but it definitely moved. Now, if you didn't want to replace this bearing, you could order a part that included, oh, there it goes again, the pulley and a new bearing already pressed into it. Well, see there, it almost went all the way through. All right, that did it. Got our old bearing out. I'm gonna have to clean this, clean the inside surface of this, kind of just maybe with like a Scotch-Brite. We don't wanna sand any of the material off. I just wanna get any of the rust and build up off of there. And then we need to press a new bearing in. So this is the bearing that came out. You can see kind of the surface that was exposed, kind of the rust. I've got two new bearings from Timken, one that I'm going to use here and one that I'll have as a backup. These are 6203-2RS. Put links to this in the description. Always good to have a backup. I'll keep this in my toolbox from when I'm away from the house. Never know when you need to replace something like this somewhere out on the trail. Wrap the plastic. Listen to the difference. All right, so I got this really old can of grease. This is my grandfather's. And I'm just gonna get a little bit of it in there. Not a lot, just a tiny, tiny bit. And it looks like some old peanut butter. And I'm just gonna kind of smear that with my finger just so there's just the tiniest little bit of something in there to give it a little help. help so it doesn't bind while I'm putting it in. Don't want it to be like super greasy and slippery. Just don't want it to bind. Yeah. All right, let's see if we can put a little clamping force on it. Could use a third hand for lining everything up and trying to keep it straight. Oh, I can see it coming in now. I've got it in there straight enough now that you can see as I push on this, it's dropping in. All right, so let's stop there. Let's check it out. Might have gone a little too far. I have to push it back. But it's in place. Kind of flush on this side, so I think I'm probably going to give it just a little bit of a push the other direction, so we're closer to where we were when we started. Probably a winner right there. We'll go put it on the Jeep. We'll look at the alignment with the other pulleys, and if we have to make an adjustment, we will. But we've got our new bearing on there. It's nice and smooth and quiet. It's not got that sort of dirty sound to it. So I hope that helped you. Please like and subscribe. I'll put more details in the description. And we'll see you in the next video. Thanks.